Hello, everyone. I'm Mark.
I'm Joel.
And welcome to another episode of the Sit Down Podcast.
What is this now? 132, 133?
Three.
Nice. Yeah. So this episode is, I'm a little excited for this one. I didn't have a clue who the frick this young woman was. And I saw her at Chesterfest.
Yeah.
For the first time, I swear to God, you guys, she blew my freaking mind. You've probably heard me say that a few times in the course of the last couple of years, but I swear to God, like of the definition of a voice of an angel.
Yeah, when you presented her name to me, I was like, okay, I'll look her up. And then I look her up and it's like, holy shit, you were not kidding.
Yeah, it's insane. I kind of did a little deep dive on her social media platforms. As far as I know, she doesn't have an album out there. I don't know if she's got any recordings. It's a lot of covers on her social media.
Yep.
Dude, her freaking TikTok is what, like 185,000 followers or something like that? I was like, what the hell?
And she's from?
Prince Albert, Saskatchewan. So.
Yep.
This young woman's name is Rebecca Strong. We're going to get to know her just as you guys are going to get to know her.
Yeah, we know very little about her aside from the stuff that she posts on social media. And you saw her at Chesterfield.
I got to meet her very briefly, shook her hand, told her she did a great job. And that was kind of the conversation. I was like, do you want to come on the show? And that's kind of how that went. But we definitely will. Before we get into that, though, we do have a couple minutes because she's not on the call just yet. Is there anything new going on with Funky Moose this week at all? I see you started doing a little bit more Instagram posts lately.
Yeah, because people keep telling me I have to do that. So
you do. You definitely do.
I do.
You do.
Yeah. That's about it. That's real news. News, I guess.
The news in Funky Moose world is Mark's doing Instagram posts.
Make a headline out of that one.
No doubt.
Yeah. We are breaking actually, news. We are. So Adam and I are working on social media plans for musicians.
Right. Well, let me stop you right there. Now take a step backwards. For the listeners and viewers out there who have no idea who Adam is, can you fill them in?
Adam Hoffert is, we met him, he's a lead singer of Small City Blues. We had him on the show with Dalton. This was a few months ago, and I must have mentioned something about that I also do digital marketing. And he hit me up after the show, and he was like, he was interested in what I did and how I did it.
Right.
And we got to talk, blah, blah, blah. We hit it off, great guy, and he's now part of the Funky Moose team.
Yeah, he is good shit.
So he is doing, he's working with me in Funky Moose Digital to help set up social media campaigns for artists and small business.
Is that window open?
It is.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I hear a lot. I'm not sure if you guys can hear that. There's a lawnmower going on. Somebody's cutting the grass out there. Yeah. Great.
Yeah, I'm going to have to shut that window. Yeah.
We're going to take a break while Mark shuts that window and we'll dive into it. So hope you guys enjoy.
Have you heard about our new radio station? It's called Funky Moose Radio, where we play alternative and indie rock, sprinkle in some blues and Americana. We feature the music from our guests on this podcast at least once per hour. These songs can be in any genre. We're working on getting the station on every mobile app available, but the easiest way to listen is at funkymooseradio.ca. You should also become a VIP because we'll be giving away some prizes. Again, check it out at funkymooseradio.ca. Hi.
Hello.
Good to meet you.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Yeah.
I'm Rebecca. What's your name?
Mark.
Mark.
Yeah.
And we met at Chesterfest very briefly. You didn't watch that 2-minute video I sent you, did you?
On
Facebook Messenger.
Yeah, I watched it. Posted it on Instagram, I think.
No, not the one from Chesterfest. The one about coming on the show and welcoming you to the show. And
no, I didn't. Oh my gosh.
It's okay.
I totally forgot about that.
It's totally okay. And the only reason I knew that you didn't watch it was because you asked Mark what his name was. Because we say that. We introduce in it, but it's all good. We're good.
Okay. Hey guys, I'm Rebecca, and this is episode 133 of the Sit Down Podcast.
Welcome to the show, Rebecca. It is an honor to have you hanging out with us this evening. I had mentioned to the audience prior to you jumping on where I met you, and I was telling them, like, you freaking blew my mind. I don't have a clue. I'm in a freaking hole. I have no idea. I know nothing about you. I did a little bit of, I creeped on you a little bit on like Instagram, Facebook, like very minimally, because I knew you were coming on, so I wanted to get to know you here. But how, like, this is such a stupid question, but how the hell did you learn how to sing like that? It's such, I told the audience the definition of a voice of an angel. It's so beautiful. Your voice is very, very beautiful. I love it.
Thank you.
Hell yeah. Have you been singing like your whole life?
Yes. Okay. So basically, my dad was a busker. Like, that's how he made a living. So he's been musical like all of his life. And when I was born, he decided to bring me and my sisters into music. So my first time singing on stage was 5 years old at Voices of the North. I was the youngest, the youngest singer on that. In that little production.
Yeah.
And so I've literally been singing on stages since five, and my dad's been teaching us and helping us practice and everything. Yeah. So
is there a video of you?
Really?
Oh
yeah.
We gotta go find that.
We gotta do a deeper dive here.
I sang Leaving on a Jet Plane. I don't know who that's by.
John Denver,
is it? I have no idea.
I think so. Yep.
Yeah.
Who did the remake of that? That was like very popular. Whoa. In the '90s. Oh, that was for the movie Armageddon.
Like 150,000 artists did that song.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah,
but yeah, good song. Great.
Yeah. So that was basically how I learned to sing.
Right.
Yeah, I don't really know what else I should talk about. Like,
well, it's just it's all good. Like, let's talk about this last summer. How many times were you able to perform on stage this summer, 2022?
Okay, this summer, not a lot, actually. I did Voices of the North, Search for the Stars. I got Senior Star for Search for the Stars and the Chester Fest.
Right.
I honestly think those are like the only shows that I've done this year. And to rephrase though, I do a lot of live concerts from my room on like TikTok.
Yes. Yeah. I definitely want to talk about that, because we have some mutual acquaintances, and I was telling them how you were coming on the show. I'll tell you who they are after, but we were talking about your TikTok, and you've got 185,000 followers on TikTok. What the frick, man?
How does that happen?
It's crazy. I don't even know how that happened. To talk about it, actually, I gained my following not from a singing video. It was just some random video that I posted on TikTok. It was like showing people like love yourself. I don't know. It was something random like that. And it got like over 2 million views, and everyone started following me from that. So then I gained that platform and said, why don't I use it to like show my music and stuff?
Hell and yeah. People
started following me
for more.
So yeah.
Smart move.
Oh yeah. My god. Oh my god. All That's right. Awesome. So a question I have is, I've got so many questions about TikTok. I don't have it. I don't use it. I'm very unfamiliar with it. but I do know of it, right? So what's the timeline there? Like, when was that first post you did on TikTok?
Okay, so I did a couple like different TikToks just for my friends. Like, right. TikTok wasn't a big thing when I first started.
Yeah.
And I think it was 2020, like right as COVID started.
Okay.
Like everyone was searching for something like to be positive about. And I posted some like feel good TikTok. Yeah. And so like, I'd say like March 2020 was that first.
Like, right. TikTok. And then, so the,
hang on, I'm just going to cut you off here because my son is.
Yeah. Mark's kid is like running around in the background here. So he's going to go be a dad here right now. But I do want, yeah, we'll take a little break here. I'll drop one of your TikToks in right here. If that's okay. That's what we'll do here.
Hold on to the end. That's what I intend to do. I'm hopelessly devoted to you. But now there's no since you push my love aside, I'm out of my head, hopelessly devoted to you, hopelessly devoted to you. Ooh, hopelessly devoted.
I feel like this should be a teach us TikTok episode.
Well, yeah. So, well, I told her, I said, we'll drop one of the TikTok clips in when you got up to go do that. But
so, what's it called? Oh, tell me about TikTok Universe. And this is the video that goes here. You're going to put the video here.
After we just played a video?
Oh, play another video? Okay. Yeah, we can put this in the background and talk about it.
All right.
Anyway, so I saw a TikTok of you being stumped by getting TikTok Universe.
Yeah. Okay. So basically, when you go live, there's gifts that people, like the viewers, can send you, and it's like real money, and like it's basically like you're paying for like a little animation plus giving like support to the creator. So Universe, TikTok Universe, is one of the biggest gifts you can get, and it like gives a notification to everyone else that's live that you got a Universe. So her name's Terry gifted it to me, and it was so crazy. Like, I didn't think I'd ever get a TikTok Universe, but I don't know how much it is, but anyways.
Okay, so I did a little bit of Googling. A TikTok Universe is worth $500, US dollars.
Yeah.
So that money goes to you then? Or it goes to TikTok?
Takes a percentage.
Yeah.
And it's a pretty hefty percentage. Right. Like,
I didn't see shit from that.
I honestly think I may have got like 150 US dollars from it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So I don't know how much TikTok takes. I've never actually done the research on it, but
that must be something similar to, like, I know you can do that kind of stuff on Twitch.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's probably the same kind of idea.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, man.
Wow. 500 bucks. You spend 500 bucks and the artist gets 150.
Yeah. It's kind of,
but hey,
well,
it's better than not getting anything.
Okay, so question is, how long ago did that happen?
It's fairly recent, right?
Yeah, like 2 months ago, maybe.
Because I wonder if, like, if TikTok just made 500 bucks off of you because of that, they might be more prone to sharing your content out there to more people.
Yeah, okay, so that's another thing. the more gifts you get and the more likes, TikTok knows that people like you, so they'll put it on more people's like feed.
Yeah, so that they can make money off of you.
Yeah.
That's exactly what that is, right?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Freaking rights. No, that's super cool. I am not like, I'm not going to go out and get TikTok by all means at all.
But you are.
No, not at all. But the question I wanted to ask you before the clip was the timeline from when you, like in 2020, from when you started it to when you started singing on TikTok. Like, was that pretty quick from when you started it? Or was that like, you know, a couple months later or a year into it, you're like, oh, I should sing on here.
Here, I'm just going to actually look, okay?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm very interested.
Okay. January, March, April. Okay, so I posted the first TikTok in April. And my sisters were telling me, you better post something singing or else you're going to lose viewers. So this is actually crazy. 2020 November was the first time I posted a singing TikTok. So that's like, how many months is that? Seven months?
That's 8 months. Yeah.
Yeah. So I waited 8 months, I guess. I didn't know it was that long, but.
So was that a matter of, oh shit, I have all of these followers now. And now I'm like, I have stage fright. I don't want to sing to TikTok or.
Okay. So I have a really like, it's not a big fear, but the internet is cruel.
Yeah.
And it's hard to put yourself out there, like on the internet where everyone can see what you love to do. You never know what they're going to say. What if they hated it?
Yeah.
Yep.
And that's what was stopping me was my own like fear of.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that must have been why I
watched one of your, I've watched so many TikTok videos in the last few hours.
I had Mark, I'll fill you in. I told Mark to like, you and I spoke this morning and I was asking like, hey, can we take some of your social media content and use it in this episode? And you gave us permission to. So I delegated Mark to go through your TikTok and find us some videos.
You asked if I wanted to, and I gladly did.
Yeah. So,
and so I saw one of you, I think it was a live video where you were singing. And as you were singing, there was some stupid comment coming in and you were blocking a hater. Bye. as you were singing, I thought that was pretty talented.
Freaking rights. That's what you have to do that, man.
There's
100%, because then the gates will just flood, right? The next question I have for you is when you started singing on TikTok and then the followers were still coming in and you were, you know, getting recognition for your music and your voice on there, has there been any, let's call it like opportunities that have risen from TikTok since you started singing on there? Do you know what I mean?
Actually, okay, we'll talk about this, but I don't know if you guys know this, but in 2019, I have a video of me singing a song by Demi Lovato on the piano on Facebook.
Yes.
And that's where my career really started.
Okay.
Is that Facebook video, because it got like over 1 million views or something. And like PA Now did a article on it. And then people started seeing it and asking me to sing at their banquets, all these different things.
Yeah.
But then COVID happened.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you were 15 at the time, I think, because the article was a CBC article that I read.
Yeah, 15.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, it is.
I wonder what the hell happened on Facebook to just make that blow up. So just everyone sharing it, maybe.
Was it your dad that took the video?
My dad
took
the video in the mirror.
Yeah.
So like I was playing the piano and he was like pretending to record me. Like I obviously knew. They don't know that.
Yeah.
But they think that my dad just like caught me singing. like practicing singing or whatever. And like it started getting a lot of views overnight. Like I think like it was like at 10K views and I was like, this has never happened before. Then it started slowly getting a lot more views. But it stopped at like 500. I don't even know what it stopped at, but yeah. I was like, this is never going to reach a million views. In 2020, early 2020, it reached a million views. That doesn't make sense. Sorry. I have no idea when it reached a million views, but
it did though. The point of the story is that it hit a million views. Yeah. Right? Like really. That's fucking amazing. Congratulations to you. And yeah. I think that's like truly deserved. Cause like I haven't heard anybody that can sing like you.
I don't think that's a mistake or anything. I don't think that's a fluke either.
I don't think so. I don't think so neither. Like, yeah. I think I just like, I want to get your voice out there as like, what, like if there's anything I can do to help to get your voice well, out that, there.
That's you know where my, I mean? That's where my head is at too. What do you want to keep making TikToks?
Yeah.
Or like, is it, do you want to.
Like the goals, dreams and aspirations. Yeah. Like what is it that you want to do with this beautiful voice of yours? Right.
Yeah. You know, that's a question that's been challenging me my whole career. Like,
yeah.
How far do I want to take this? And I was just in university for my first year of arts and science. And I was thinking, oh, do I really want to do this? Like, what do I want? Like a degree or like focusing on music where music may not even work out.
Right.
Music may not work out. I don't believe that.
I took the initiative and this year I'm focusing on music.
Hell yes.
So
yes,
I finally made the decision.
Nice.
And I'm hoping like bringing it back to the whole TikTok thing, like opportunities that have opened up since then.
Yeah.
Last year, they asked me to audition for America's Got Talent. A producer.
Yeah.
Reached out to me, a casting director, sorry. And I did try out, but it just wasn't my time. I wasn't ready for it.
Right. I'm sure there was a lot of nerves and stuff going on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
I auditioned for Canada's Got Talent, didn't get in. That's past me, but whatever.
Right. Was that all like pretty recent?
Yeah. Yeah. So like 2021.
Yeah.
Yeah. Pretty recent.
Frickin' right. Huh. And well, that's that those types of experiences, I think will in the career that you're about to pursue, I think you're going to get a lot of those opportunities. Not all of them. It's like you're not going to get yes all the time. No. Right. But it just doesn't like the no's don't mean no forever. They just mean no right now.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, exactly. It doesn't mean that you can't try out again next year. That way you'll have another year of experience under your belt. And then that way you'll be able to conquer some more fears or confidence things or whatever it is, why they said no. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I understand. And
so like, don't let those bring you down at all. Because when I saw you at Chester Fest, like fucking tears were coming down my face. I couldn't believe it, man. It was, I get a little weepy sometimes when I hear good music, man. And you definitely... definitely hit that spot that day. That was one of my favorite performances that day.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
So do you write your own music?
I've tried. I have like a bunch of notes in my phone that are just random, like,
yeah.
Like one time I woke up and I was like, whoa, I have so many things I need to write down right now. And like I just pulled out like a voice memo and like thought of like a melody, and they're all like unfinished, like I don't know how to take it further. So I'm trying my best to write some music because I know a lot of people want to hear something from me instead of like a cover.
Yeah.
And I won like a recording package in 2020, and I still haven't used it yet because of COVID, and like,
yeah,
it's just coming around. So hopefully soon I start working on something.
So I think who you need is a producer who can help you convert the voice memos that you have in your phone and turn that into full songs.
That's one way for sure. Like every artist needs a producer for sure.
Yeah.
I would almost say, like, you've been singing since you were 5 years old. You definitely know some other people in the area and province that are like in the industry, right? I'm very confident that you're friends with some of them, and I wouldn't be opposed to like just collaborate with them.
Yeah.
You know, if you know somebody who's singing and songwriting, just be like, hey, can we freaking go for coffee and like, let's just do a little, show me how you do it. And then that way it like, there's inspiration that comes out of that. And then you can get a feel for your way of doing it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I would do that with as many people as I can.
Cause sometimes I look in her eyes, and that's where I find a glimpse of us. And I try to fall for a touch, but I'm thinking of the way you was. Said I'm fine, said I moved on. I'm only here passing time in her arms, hoping I'll find a glimpse of us.
Yeah, I totally agree. I just thought of something. I actually have featured on a song. Oh boy. Just wait. Let me find the name of it.
Yeah.
Okay. It's called Take a Knee. It's by Benson and C.O. And it's featuring me. And basically it's about missing and murdered Indigenous women.
Right.
And George Floyd. Is that his name?
Yep. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
That's what the song is based around. Okay. And yeah, I did a little verse on that, and it is on YouTube if you guys wanted to check it out. I don't know if you guys heard it.
I have not, but I'm definitely going to look it up now.
Yeah.
I don't think we can play it in this episode,
but
what we'll do is we'll put the link of that video as well in the description to this one. So the you guys out there watching or listening, definitely check this song out for sure.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So that was like, who were those people? Like, where are they from?
Okay. I wish I knew. I wish I got to know Benson more, but he's a little rapper, a little Indigenous rapper. And
is he the one out of like freaking, not Birch Hills, but is it Nipawin? Is he from Saskatchewan?
Yes.
Okay. Is it like Nipawin or Birch Hills or something like that?
Let me see, actually.
Milford?
I feel like I think I tried hitting him up. Like,
I think I know who you're talking about too.
Yeah. I think I know who you're talking about. He was like didn't he make the paper or something? He was in the like North Sask music scene.
Yeah.
I think if that's the same guy.
Can't find it now.
I did a whole paper on like Indigenous music artists, and he was in my paper. So I don't know why I don't know.
That's okay.
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah.
But so he hit you up then and asked if you could do something on his track or what?
Yeah.
Right on.
With Reservoir Recordings. I don't know if you guys know who that is.
Yep. Jordy.
Yeah.
Cool.
That's
pretty awesome. I had to write like my own verse. It was my first time.
Oh.
Like really seriously writing something, but I think it turned out pretty awesome.
I'm gonna look that up.
Fuck yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm definitely gonna check it out. And that link is in this description. Also, okay, so that was pretty recent, and I don't know. I would just say those voice notes that you're doing, man, keep doing that, because that is, you are writing. That's how 90% of the people that we talk to, that's what they do. They'll wake up in the middle of the night and they've got a lyric or a melody or something.
Yeah.
Like, just get it down, man. That's all it is. That way you've got it. You can always come back to it. You might not use it for the next 5 years.
Yep.
But you'll always have it. And you,
exactly.
Yeah, this will fit here. This can go here. So just.
And sometimes you can combine it. Those voice notes into a song.
Fuck yeah.
Exactly. Yeah.
Right on. But yeah. I would also highly recommend, like there's so many great musicians in the Prince Albert area. There's like, you've got people like Jake Vadeland. You've got LJ Tyson. The North Sound's not out of Prince Albert, no, but like Forrest, I'm sure would like, Forrest would be a good one to just hit him up and be like, hey, can we go for coffee? And like, can you teach me your ways? I'm very confident he'd be down with it. And I highly encourage it. I think great things are going to come out of you.
But I still think something like a producer or somewhat like even Jordy. Jordy wrote music. He writes music for others and he does music with others. I'm sure he'll sit down with you and just, you know, chat.
Yeah.
That's all you need to start.
Exactly.
Hey, have you heard about Muse Canada? It's an inclusive nationwide collective for all arts, culture, and entertainment communities to provide communication, opportunity, and resources through networking and essential activism.
Yeah, they're all about connecting folks in the arts, cultures, and entertainment industries. Most importantly, they cross-connect across those industries, right? So musicians to filmmakers, photographers to artists, to crafts, to peoples, to you name it, that's what they're trying to do. They welcome individuals, businesses, non-for-profits, associations, bands, and basically everything, you guys. So if you haven't heard of who they are, just give them a quick look-see at moosecanada.ca.
Moosecanada.ca.
Muse.
Because Moose, it's us.
Did I say Moose?
You did.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
It should be Moose. Yeah.
So I see you did some collaborations on TikTok as well. Is there an artist that makes you go like, if I can collaborate with him or her, that'd be sweet.
Oh boy. I've always loved Adele. Adele has been my muse for my whole entire life. So if I ever got to sing with her at all, or even just see her sing, I would like go crazy. But another one is, I love Billie Eilish music.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Like, her songs are awesome. And yeah.
And you do a few of her songs too.
I haven't really given that much thought though. Like, I've never really thought about who I'd like to collaborate with.
Right.
And I like that you went for the biggest names in music right now. Right away.
<Yeah. laughs> No fucking around here. Yeah. Let's go.
Yeah.
Hell yes. Okay, so the summer, like, the last show that you got to play was Chesterfest this year. Do you have anything lined up coming up maybe in the next couple months, or...
That's a good question.
Or not at all.
Not really.
Have you ever heard, did you know, well, I guess you just turned 19, or how long have you been 19 for?
I just turned 19 on the 1st.
Holy shit.
Happy belated birthday.
Yeah.
No doubt. Well, let me plant a little seed in your ear. I do not know if anything like this goes on in Prince Albert. But I can tell you that Tuesday nights at the Capitol in Saskatoon, there's open mic nights there. So like there's a sign up sheet. So you go, you sign your name down, right? Like whatever song you're going to perform or sing, take the stage.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
And work it out.
And you got three songs, right? Two or three songs?
I'm not sure exactly.
I think it's three songs.
But and you said you play the piano too?
Yeah, a little bit. I'm self-taught. I dabble.
Yeah, but I mean, you could, like, if there's a cover song that you know how to play, like on the keys or something.
Yeah.
You could just sit down and play and sing a song or three.
Exactly.
Fuck yeah. And then they vote after, like, who is their favorite and stuff. It's, I think I would highly, I'll fucking take you to one. Let's go.
Yeah, I'll bring you, awesome.
I'll bring you to an open mic, like, more than once in Saskatoon, just to, like, keep it fresh and keep it going. You know what I mean?
Yeah, exactly. That's frickin' awesome. Right. Well, thanks for telling me about that.
Well, I just want to see you on stage, girl. you need to be on the stage. You have to be.
Unless you don't want to be. We don't want to push you or anything.
Unless you don't want to. That's right. I'm not forcing you to be. Do anything. But I mean, that's, I think maybe something like that. Prince Albert, do you know if they have anything like that? Open mics?
There's a karaoke.
There is? Have you heard of that? You know who Gary O is, right?
Yeah, that's who I have the recording package with.
Oh, right on. He's a resident at Prince Albert Brewing Company.
Oh, really?
And he does, I think it's Wednesday nights, I want to say.
It could very well be.
Wednesday night, he does karaoke. And it's, I want to say it's pretty much an open mic. Or is it actual karaoke?
I don't know. I've never been to one.
No, me neither. I've heard about it.
He's the nicest freaking guy. Yeah. He was at Chester Fest too. He was like helping moving equipment, setting up and everything. Yeah, he's good shit, man.
Yeah.
I went to his New Year's Eve party.
Oh,
he invited me and my family over.
Oh,
right. Oh, like at his house.
Yeah. Him and my dad are like buddies.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well.
There's a guy who he knows how to write too. He's a great writer. I think you should use that package just to keep it going, even if it's like that kickstart to get you out on your own and doing all that, even if it's to just get you started or whatever the case may be. Shout out to Gary O, man. When are you coming back on the show, Gary?
Yeah.
That guy's awesome.
Yes.
Are you inviting yourself into his house again?
I want him to come here.
Okay. Sure.
He should come here, I think. Yeah. But yeah, there's like I said before, I think you need to be on the stage.
With a voice like yours, there are plenty of opportunities.
Thank you.
Yeah. And with that being said too, not all of them are going to be good ones neither. No. So just be, you know, weary of what's coming your way and don't be scared to say no. I see that too in a lot of new people. They'll just say yes to absolutely everything and then you'll burn yourself out immediately.
Yep. Exactly.
So just, and I think you've been doing a pretty good job at that from what I've heard through the grapevine and stuff. Like, I think you're pretty conscious of what's going on around you and who you can trust and all that kind of stuff. So like, good on you for that.
Thank 100%. You.
Keep that up. Definitely.
So you said you and your sister, is your sister still musically inclined?
Yes. So I have two sisters. Allison and Amanda. Allison, she has a few songs on the radio. Allison Ray Strong. I don't know if you've ever, like, on NBC, she plays a lot on there.
Okay.
I think the past couple months she's been like number, like top five in NBC countdown or whatever.
Now that you mention it, it does
ring a bell.
And my dad also has a lot of songs on NBC. Glenn cool. Strong.
Hell yeah.
Okay.
No, that's awesome.
But for those of you who don't know, NBC is officially a radio station out of LaRonge, but they operate out of Prince Albert. Correct?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice. So why? So have you not, like, this might be a mundane, stupid question and
it is.
You don't have to answer it if you don't want to, but have you not, like, asked your sister and your dad about, like, writing techniques or anything like that?
Or is it
weird because they're family?
I don't know. It's like, whenever I try to talk to my dad about like serious, like, music things, it's just always like, it's like hard to take my family seriously.
Yeah.
I don't know what it is, but like, it's just like not something I would do.
Right. You know? No, it makes sense. And I think that's because they are your family.
Yeah.
That's all that is.
And it's hard to hear like criticism from people that you're close to.
Yeah.
Because then that's all I think about. Like, oh, do you remember that one time they said that that note sucked?
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Or it's like they can't appreciate the job. It's not that they don't appreciate the job that you're doing, but if they're watching you perform, they feel obligated to critique you and point out the bad things or where you, and it's like, can't you just say good job?
Like, exactly.
I don't need to hear all the negative all the time. Like
that is so true.
Yeah. I get it for sure.
Yeah.
So that makes sense. Definitely.
Yeah.
Have you ever met, like, I'm sure you have, but Justin, LJ Tyson, have you ever met LJ or got to talk to that guy at all?
I've known him since like I was a little kid, like for Voice of the North.
Yeah.
I have. Of course. Yeah.
That's what I mean. Like, I know, you know, a lot of those people, like those are the people that I would be, the people who are in it and that are doing it. I'd be hitting them up and just, you know, hit up as many shows as you can, get to know some people.
A duet, LJ and her?
It could very well be. Could be. LJ, I know I promised you that video at Galaxy Cinema, but so we had LJ on, I don't know, a couple months ago when his music video dropped, and I was like telling him how I'm going to walk into Galaxy Cinemas and I was going to have them play his music video prior to the movies that they were playing, because he had that opportunity at one point in his career, and I was like, fuck, if I gotta walk in there myself, I'm gonna make it happen. Never happened. But I did run into him at the exhibition, and I'm like, dude, and he's like, fuck, he's like, I didn't expect you to do that anyway, so it's okay. So that's not happening. But yeah, man, just all those people are good people.
I agree.
Yeah. Okay, now I guess we touched on the social media, and that's really the only place people can find where to hear you singing, right? Is on like TikToks, Instagram, Facebook, all that kind of stuff, right?
YouTube, yeah.
I'm going to put in that video I sent you from Chesterfest. I'm going to drop that in here right now just so the viewers and people can see what I saw. Okay. I don't have like the full song, and I had to put it down. I was like, I gotta listen.
I'm crying. I can't.
Yeah, that's pretty. Janelle laughs at me. My wife laughs at me all the time because when I go to shows, I don't know. Sometimes there's like, you know, that there'll be a note that's just hit perfect or whatever it is.
Harmonies do it.
And it fucking hits me like in my soul, man. I feel it in my soul, and I just start weeping. It's so stupid. I get a little teary eyed just talking about it. But anyways. Here's the clip of Rebecca at Chesterfest. I'm happy for you. Don't be so cold, cold. Well, I wish I could mend this, but here's my goodbye. I'm happy for you. That's the shit that I'm talking about. Like, that's the kind of stuff that hits me. Yeah.
Yep.
100%. That was a very well done performance. There's another dude that we know. Nick Aiken?
Yeah. Nick Aiken.
Right. I actually just got to meet that fine young lad a couple weekends ago. And he's going to be coming on the show too. We haven't locked in an official date because I know he's going back to university right now, but he will be a guest on the show here coming up for sure. He was another one there. I saw him at Candle Lake, actually, at that Prince Albert Country Music Association thing that they did, fundraising event. I was there. I thought he did a really good job. So I went and I talked to him after, kind of like what I did with you. And it was just like, holy shit, man, right on. Like, I got this little rinky-dink show here. Do you want to come hang out with us for an hour?
That's awesome.
That's kind of how that went down. But
I honestly love the setup of you guys's room there.
Of the studio? Yeah, there's like my I love my view because it's like there's vinyl records everywhere. It's just out of frame here, and like some posters of concerts we went to and everything. So I love My View.
My View is boxes.
Well, you know, actually, it's funny you bring up the studio here, because I was watching our episode. Shout out to Christian de la Luna, because I freaking love that guy. And I noticed how like the background of this, like for what the viewers are seeing, is like very like reflective of our personalities. Like if you like all the shit and clutters like on my side, and your side's just like the moose. Like that's all it is. Anyways, that's neither here nor there. It just is what it is.
That actually makes sense, because this is how your brain is.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
And this is my brain.
That's
yeah, yeah. I get it.
Yeah.
I get it.
And I picked up on that. Anyways. Hell yes.
Yeah.
Say, are there any other instruments that you play besides the piano?
I play the ukulele sometimes. Just when I can. When my nails aren't too long.
Were you self-taught with that as well?
Yeah.
Nice. I just
teach myself random things.
Freaking rights.
One thing I do want to learn though is the saxophone. I don't know why.
Oh,
that'd be so awesome to learn. Like I only know one saxophone player in PA, and it is oh boy, I don't even know his name. Greg. I think his name's Gregory.
Okay.
Anyways, he used to play saxophone for our church.
Mm, okay.
Back when. And yeah, so.
Yeah.
Saxophone is an interesting
instrument.
Yeah. We, so I'm from Holland, and we have two world-renowned saxophone players from Holland. Not that I know them personally.
But, yeah.
And so Candy Dilfer is her name, the daughter, and she actually plays the saxophone on Prince's I don't remember which track it is, but there's a saxophone in there, and that's her.
Interesting.
Out of Holland.
Right on. I only know one saxophone player. I've met a couple of them, but I only like know one of them. Would be Mike Reese. Is it Reese or Rice? That's how well I know the guy from the Radiant.
Okay. I don't know his last name. Mike.
I think he actually teaches it. Well, I know he's like I think he teaches music. But okay. But him, and then there's the guy that we've had him on the show, and I can't remember his name.
Maybe Mike can teach her.
From the wilderness. Well, that's what I was thinking. Mike. Like we could definitely put you in touch with Mike and Mike.
Oh, is it Nick from the wilderness?
Yes, I think so.
Yeah, yeah.
I think it's Nick.
But he's in Ontario, so he.
No, he's in. They're playing at freaking.
Well, now, yeah. Coors Event, the wilderness is from Ontario.
I'm gonna go say hi to him. Huh. Yeah. Anyways, yeah, I can put the call out for somebody to show you how to play that if you want.
That'd be awesome.
I think it'd be fun, and then you guys could like collab and write together.
Yeah.
Freaking rights.
Exactly.
Rebecca's first song. Her own song will feature a saxophone. How's that?
I think you should do it.
That'd be awesome.
I was serious about bringing you to an open mic in Saskatoon. If you're down, let's do it. Let's go hang out.
Yeah, I'm so down.
We'll figure that out for sure. I think.
How are you going to do that though? Because.
We'll figure it out. We'll figure it out. Mark's just like, we record podcasts on Tuesdays. So I might have to call in sick one day so that me and Rebecca can go to the Capitol. All right. I know how we can do it. We can just record in the afternoon. One day.
We'd have to. Yeah.
Anyways.
We'll just move a recording.
Yeah, we'll move a recording. And, and
if that means she can go on stage, we'll make it work.
And we'll take clips of you. we'll take clips of you on the open mic stage, and then we'll feature those little clips in the podcast here and be like, hey, you remember when we said we were going to go with Rebecca? We did it.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'd be fun.
Cool.
Yeah, I want to encourage you to take the stage as much as possible. Any type of encouragement I can do, Rebecca, I want you to know that we have your back. If there's anything we can ever do to help you out,
absolutely.
Please just hit us up.
Of course.
Definitely. I'm very honored that you took the time to come sit here with us. I want to hear more. I need to hear more. So good. So anything I can do to make that happen, I will do.
Well, thank you so much.
100%.
You're part of the Moose family.
Yes, you are officially. This platform, this door is wide open for you. Use us in any way that you can. Wow. We'd be happy to help with anything.
Wow.
Use me in any way. But yeah, with that being said, I think we'll let you go. Actually, you stick around for a couple minutes and we'll just say goodbye to the watchers and listeners. Click the links in the description below here, you guys, for some more content from Rebecca. And yes, don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel. And
see you next week.
Bye, guys.
Bye.